morning, city come to order.
Receive and read.
Thank you.
Ms. Neikirk, as you described, y'all went through a process to help the chairman, Billy, to establish his budget presentation, correct?
That's correct.
And prior to that time, you had these public meetings where folks like the sheriff's office and other departments came to the full commission and presented their budgets, right?
That's correct.
And before that, that's when they had met with your office, you and Natalie, to go over their budget.
Yes, sir.
And in your budget, you include the phrase requested and recommended. Do you know those two phrases?
Yes, sir.
And do you ever establish or insert the recommended numbers on behalf of the county?
The recommended numbers?
Recommended numbers.
I think what happens is when we go through some of the line items, there's like a, Natalie will look at the trend and see what the trend is, and she'll put that in there as a recommendation.
Right.
However, the chairman changes that quite often.
Or the board, right?
Or the board, yes, sir.
But in this case, that's what you did, is you and your office or folks under your direction put in some recommended numbers, right?
But we never add like big things. You know, we look at the trend.
Right.
You know, like if somebody's asking for, I don't know, a $25,000 item or something, we don't include that into the recommendation or anything like that, because that's up to the board to make that determination.
And in this case, as to the sheriff's budget, your office gave him the recommended numbers that your office was going to insert the morning they came over to present to the Board of Commissioners on July the 5th of 2017.
Can you say that again?
In this case, in connection with the sheriff's office budget for 2018, you all gave him, that is you and your office, gave the recommended numbers from your department the morning of July 5, 2017, as they were coming in to meet with the full Board of Commissioners.
I remember us meeting with him, but I honestly don't remember if the recommended numbers were already in there or not.
Or whether you gave those to him on July the 5th. You just don't remember.
I don't. I'm sorry.
All right. And you've described the tedious process that the chairman went through to put together his recommended budget, right?
Yes, sir.
He worked very hard, as I believe your phrase was, he went through it with a fine-tooth comb.
He did, yes, sir.
And then he walked into a meeting of the Board of Commissioners. Is that showing up on your screen?
Yes, sir.
And this is what he presented, right?
Yes.
And that date is August the 10th of 2017, correct?
Yes, sir.
And there was, in accord with the processes as you described, there were to be public hearings, and the first was scheduled for August the 17th, 2017, correct?
I believe so.
All right. Now, at this time, were y'all merely approving the budget, or were you approving the budget and the millage rate?
I think it was just the budget. I don't remember.
All right. And the, just for purposes of our record, can you tell us what a millage rate is?
Yes, sir. Millage rate is the rate that the citizens are taxed upon for their personal property and their real estate. It's called a millage rate because it's based on thousands.
Okay. And if the digest goes up, that is your overall value of the property in the county that's subject to taxation, if that goes up, your real property, but your millage rate stays the same, then the law deems that a tax increase, correct?
That is correct.
All right. And that's what happened for Dawson County in 2017, which funds the 2018 budget. Is that correct?
Yes.
So the real property tax digest, the ad valorem tax digest, went up.
Yes, sir.
All right. But as you recall, the millage rate stayed the same.
That's correct.
All right. That's still deemed a tax increase.
Yes, it is.
All right. So then you've described on direct the public meetings that were held regarding this budget, right?
Yes, sir.
Until it was ultimately approved on September the 21st of 2017.
Yes, sir.
All right. I'm going to show you a document that contains changes, and this has been put in, Judge, with our Exhibit 13, I'm sorry, our Exhibit 14, and I believe it's also included as one of the exhibits that Ms. Frey has offered. Now, I want to focus here at the bottom. I'll have to turn it this way, I think, to make it to where we can read it. Try one other way here, if I can get it where you can read it. Right here, the board would like to put forth the suggestion that if the departments and offices funded by the county continue to do a great job of staying under budget for 2017 and revenue continues upward trend, a 2% salary increase could be added to the budget in April 2018. That would be a year since the salary study changes were implemented, right?
Yes, sir.
Did you prepare this document, Ms. Neikirk?
Yes, I did.
All right. And you put that language in. Did you come up with that language or were those instructions given to you?
Those were instructions.
All right. And those were instructions for proposed changes to the 2018 budget by the board.
Yes, sir.
And you sent that out on August the 11th, correct?
If you say that's the date, well, I sent it.
I want you to testify today. So y'all had a hearing on August the 17th, correct?
I believe so.
And you mentioned about how the sheriff and I were able to attend y'all's meetings and have discussions, correct?
Yes, sir.
And this letter dated August 17, 2017 from my office, correct?
This letter is from your office? I'm sorry, I'm not sure what you're asking.
I'm asking if you're referring to the exhibit.
This is attached to my complaint. So it's in the record. And within there, we go through some concerns about when the public hearings are scheduled, correct?
Yes, sir.
All right. And references that we received an email August the 11th containing a list of proposed changes to the FY 2018 budget. Right?
Yes, sir.
Those proposed changes were not discussed in any public meeting after the chairman presented his budget presentation on August the 10th and these changes were recommended on August the 11th. Is that correct?
I honestly am not sure about the dates. I mean, I know those changes were made after the chairman made his proposed presentation. So,
right.
But I don't know exact for the dates. I'm sorry.
All right. Tell the judge when these changes, and there's 20 changes or so here, aren't they?
Yes, sir.
All right, when those proposed changes were made, they were never initially discussed in a public meeting. They were merely adopted as part of the approved budget on September the 21st. Is that correct?
I think that's correct. I mean, these changes came about from recommendations that other board members wanted. So that was where these recommendations came from.
All right, and I understand your answer. And the other board members, you've told us on direct, it came from Commissioner Nix and Commissioner Gaines. Were there other board members who made changes that are inserted here?
I'm not sure. I think they had other outside conversations that I was not a part of.
All right. But you were a part of the conversation in your office and instructed, as you told us, to make these changes.
Yes, sir.
And all of that occurred in your office and did not occur at a public meeting.
That's correct.
And that was after the chairman had gone through the tedious process of combing through to make his presentation, right?
Yes, sir.
All right. And would you agree with me that these changes that were first announced in your office ultimately became the budget, the changes to the budget that were approved a month later?
I believe that's correct, sir.
And the initial, that you've described the hearings that you understand are required for a budget, you said only one's required, but you usually recommend two, but that in this case there were three, correct?
Yes, sir.
What happened was that the initial hearing scheduled for August the 17th didn't qualify, did it, as a proper public hearing?
I don't know.
You don't know? And isn't it true that the enacting legislation requires that the chairman's budget, which he did on the 10th, has to be noticed and provided to the public for a specific period of time before the public hearing is proper, right?
I believe it was put on the website.
Okay, but it has to be advertised, correct?
Yes, sir.
In the newspaper, and they missed that deadline, right?
I'm not aware of us missing a deadline.
You're not aware of an issue come down, the advertisement for the August 17 public hearing did not publish until August 9. Budget was not published until August 11th, therefore it fails to meet the requirements of being provided notice at least 10 days before the hearing. You're just not aware of that?
No, I mean, I know that you have to have it advertised, but we had the other hearings as well, so I felt like that covered it.
Okay. And I understand, that's what I'm asking. It was your testimony, there were three hearings to discuss the budget.
Yes, sir.
All right, and those three hearings, the first was August the 17th, right?
Mm-hmm. Yes, sir.
And then there was another public hearing, just an open public hearing, and then you described a special public meeting for the sheriff to come over, right?
Yes, sir.
All right. Now, and you attended all of those.
Yes, sir.
All right. And so the one that involved the sheriff's presentation and was specific to the sheriff, as you've described, that was held on September the 19th, just 2 days before the September 21st adoption, correct?
I believe so.
All right. Now, at that public meeting, the minutes that were kept are just action minutes, right? In other words, they won't go through the specific of what each speaker states, correct?
That's correct.
All right. And at that public meeting, do you recall Commissioner Nix discussing at length with the sheriff a January of 2017 order that his office had made? Do you recall that at all?
I do. I recall her discussing something that was ordered.
From January of 2017 that she discussed with the sheriff on September the 19th of 2017, some 8 months later.
I'm sorry, I'm drawing a blank.
Okay. Had you ever discussed that January 2017 bill with the sheriff during this tedious process to develop this budget?
What was the bill for?
Well, I'm asking you, you ever discussed the January 2017 bill with Sheriff Johnson throughout this process to create his budget?
I honestly don't recall.
All right. And do you recall Commissioner Fawcett accusing the sheriff of taking action that breached a warrant?
I remember her asking something about, was it an HVAC unit? I believe it was an HVAC unit. I think it was something about the HVAC unit warranty.
And tell the judge when that HVAC unit was repaired.
I think it was January.
All right.
I think it was January.
And so she brought that up for the first time, to your knowledge, to Sheriff Johnson on September the 19th, 2017, 2 days before they were to vote on his 18 budget. Right?
I believe so.
All right. And then, again, this is attached to our petition. Sheriff requested specific information regarding the claim asserted that from the commissioners during the proceeding on September 19 that the sheriff's office somehow voided a warranty. When and how? Were you ever directed to provide any information to the sheriff's office regarding the claims that he somehow affected a warranty?
No, sir.
And to your knowledge, no information was provided to the sheriff to support any such claim?
No, sir. That would not be something that would come from my office anyway.
It would not?
Not the warranty part. No,
all right,
sir.
Well, what about any notice about a purchase or an expenditure? That would come from you, correct?
Yes, sir.
All right. Now, do you also recall during that meeting on September the 19th of questions being posed by Commissioner Fawcett about vendor gifts to the sheriff's office and being concerned about Pyrex plates being provided to the sheriff's office as a result of the size of order they had made?
I don't remember that.
But that was at least a good part of the dialogue, as you described it, that occurred between the sheriff and at least two of the commissioners on September the 19th. Was the bill from January, the HVAC work from January, and Pyrex plates?
Your Honor, I think that the witness's testimony is being mischaracterized. She just said she didn't know.
You'll have a redirect.
You can answer.
I remember the part about the warranty being, you know, mentioned, but I really don't remember the part about the Pyrex plates.
Okay. So that at least adds to, but you do remember about the bill from Commissioner Nix from January of 2017?
Yes, sir.
All right. So as to those two items, that was, would you agree that that was a significant part of what you characterize as the dialogue between the commissioners and the sheriff's office at that meeting on September the 19th?
To the best of my knowledge,
all right.
Yes.
Now, when the chairman presented his recommendations, he did a comparison there for us from FY18 proposed and FY2017, and I put it up here on the board as part of one of our exhibits, Judge. You would agree with me, would you not, that this comparison is from the initial approved FY2017 budget?
That's correct.
And it does not include the amendments to the 2017 budget that were made in April of 2017.
That is correct.
And as of the time that this comparison was given, the FY2017 budget had been amended, but those numbers are not provided here.
That is correct.
All right. Now, in the chain of command over at the county, you report to county manager Headley, correct?
Yes, sir.
And there had been times prior to this budget being presented, but going back into the spring of 2017, when the sheriff would seek to have a certain payment made, and your office would notify Mr. Headley that the request violated the county policies that you must follow, correct?
Yes, sir.
And explain to him you needed, you understood the sheriff may be able to approve that, but you needed some direction from him, right?
That's correct.
All right, were you ever informed, or did you ever receive a copy of the memorandum that Mr. Headley sent to the sheriff that stated June 5th of 2017 regarding the status of purchasing and personnel decisions?
I don't believe I received a copy of this, but I think I have seen it.
All right. So what were the circumstances under which you saw it?
I believe Mr. Headley showed me the copy.
In here it says, that if the sheriff and his staff didn't handle contractual and other arrangements, he does so, and your office does so on its own, they'll have appropriate policies in place, train staff to enable you to stay in compliance with all applicable Georgia and federal statutes, etc. You see all that?
Yes, sir.
All right. And can you tell the judge, did you ever report to Mr. Headley that there was any issue with what the sheriff was requesting you to do other than the county policies?
No, sir. Our problem was trying to make sure that we were following policy, and sometimes we were not able to.
Move in here. Do you have anything to do with what's referenced as other legal pitfalls come up in recruitment, hiring? Is any of that under your direction or control?
No, sir. That's under
HR.
HR.
All right. Now, if Mr. Headley went over this with you, were you given a copy of our reply that was dated June the 20th?
I don't remember seeing this.
All right. Down here, let it settle. Sheriff and I suggest that appropriate forms be prepared to present to county staff to allow the sheriff to exercise the authority granted by law without preemption by any conflicting county ordinance or policy. Were you ever consulted by Mr. Headley about participating in creating whatever form would allow you to proceed with the sheriff's office request?
No, sir, I don't believe so.
Now, when the budget was approved, let me see if your office is this a form that your office creates? I know it's hard to read,
yes, sir.
It is the form y'all create.
All right. Yes, sir.
Now, Ms. Neikirk, I want to go right here. We're going to look at the number $600,000, okay?
Yes.
And if we scroll up, that's under the SPLOST 6, right?
Right.
Okay. And as you've testified, those funds are funds that the voters approved. In this case, the voters had approved that in 2015, right?
Yes, sir.
And so, actually, 14 started collecting in 15, right?
That's correct.
And it's used for those specific purposes, correct?
That's correct.
And that's one of those funds that the sheriff doesn't have complete discretion over these SPOS funds, does he?
That's correct.
And in fact, that is voted on, the amount to be spent, and in what purpose has to be voted on and approved by the Board of Commissioners.
That's right.
All right. Now, in this case, in the verified answer that we have, scroll you back up so you can see everything, and then I'll come back in as we need. But the response that we receive says that, let me start with paragraph 5 first. Says that petitioner is the sheriff, submitted a proposed budget for the sheriff's office for 18 by the Board of Commissioners, and that petitioner requested a sum in excess of $8.9 million for general fund and capital combined, and claimed that the total budget request was for $10,530,498. And show that the sheriff's total approved budget was $9,173,080. You see that?
Yes, sir.
Then if we go to paragraph 8, we have the same number, which provided the sheriff's office with allocation of 2018 expenditures in the total amount of $9,173,080. Right?
I see that, yes, sir.
All right. And down here shows, it says that the sheriff is entitled to move fund around between the line items and divisions within his approved budget, which amount was previously shown to us. The approved budget, according to this answer, is 9-1. Which he knows has done and has been encouraged by the board to do, and that he still has that authority, right?
Yes, sir.
And if we go back to this, and I'm happy to provide you with a calculator, but I'll tell you that there's been prior testimony that the total column over here for sheriffs, just for sheriffs, mm-hmm. minus the 260 where there's a restriction. That's in the capital project fund, and that's what the board restricted pursuant to those changes, correct?
Yes.
And minus these grant funds of 112,204 and 4,040, minus the 15,000 that was removed for SWAT, that these totals for sheriff services comes out to $9,173,080. And that would include the SPLOST. And he does not have discretion to move that around. Is that correct?
Your Honor, can I ask that he clear that up, the question? He said that doesn't have discretion to move that around?
I do.
What it is that's being referred to as not movable.
Yeah, go ahead. Thank you. He doesn't have discretion to move $600,000 between line items, right?
It's my understanding, because it's SPLOST, then it has to be spent for the purpose that the voters voted on.
All right. And SPLOST money cannot be spent for salaries or for personnel items, can it?
That's correct.
the SPOSS collections for 2017 were up 16.35% compared to 2016. Is that right?
I believe that's close. I don't have anything in front of me to look at.
Your office publishes a finance monthly report. You do that every month, right?
Yes, sir.
Available online?
Mm-hmm.
Does this look like, I know we put some writing on it, but does this look like the form that you all create?
Yes, that's part of the key indicator report.
All right. And that shows that the SPLOST collections were up 16.35%?
Compared to 16, yes, sir.
And up 18.72 over projections?
Yes, sir.
All right. And that the local option sales tax, which goes into the general fund, is at 16.35% above compared to 2016, right?
Yes, sir.
All right. And because you have an agreement with this SPLOST, the SPLOST will run for 6 years and won't be capped at the amount set forth in the resolution, correct?
It was my understanding, yes, that it would not be capped.
Okay. So if the projections are up, it's an indication that there may be more SPLOST money when this expires in 2021, that there may be SPLOST money available for capital project items, correct?
That's correct.
The CAD system qualifies as a capital project item, doesn't it?
It is a capital project item.
And in this SPLOST, this is part of our Exhibit 1, Your Honor. The SPLOST that was approved by the Board of Commissioners and by them approved in the referendum by the voters provides for the Sheriff's Office to receive $3,883,000, right?
That's the estimated, yes.
All right. And if that's divided by six, then of course that number exceeds $600,000 annually, correct?
Yes, sir.
Now, being in the finance office with the county, you're aware of in other words, the county, the overall health of the county, y'all collect and you receive. And Dawson County receives, and it's on one of the pie charts, but the total revenue coming into the county, to the general fund, coming from sales tax money, is approximately 42%. Is that correct?
I believe that's close.
All right, go ahead. Do you have something there? I saw you getting ready to look
at
something.
Let's see. I don't have it.
All right, well, hang on. I think we've got
Ben, do you have something? Don't I have something back there that shows you the...
We've got them. We've got y'all's exhibits.
Oh, okay. Lynn, if you'll hand me the budget book, I know it's in there. Yeah, it's in the budget book.
Well, but you had some updated ones from there, didn't you? Or no?
Well, this will show the 18 budget, what the percentages are. As far as what we budgeted, you know, for what are you talking about, for revenue sources?
Yeah. Revenue sources.
Yeah.
I'm gonna give you that specific.
Yeah. That's yes, that's it. Thank you.
just tell us what page you're on.
Sure.
Sure.
This is the budget guide or the budget book?
This is the budget book that we just, we have published and then we sent to GFOA.
And what's it say on the front and the back?
2018 budget guide is R10.
Yeah. And just give us a page?
On page 20.
Just a second.
All right, for general fund, yeah. Property taxes, almost 42%, and sales tax is 25.6.
And other taxes?
Mm-hmm, that's usually includes the alcohol taxes and the insurance premium tax.
All right, and so when these are, these two numbers are combined, you're, looks like about 38.9% comes from the local option sales tax and other taxes, is that correct?
That's correct.
And that the ad valorem property taxes fund significantly less than 50% of the general fund, is that correct?
41.9%.
Okay, and in most counties, the ad valorem property tax is 50% or greater. Would you agree with that?
In my experience, yes.
All right. And an indication, that's an indication of the commercial retail strength of Dawson County, is that correct?
That is correct.
All right, and in fact, in 2017, the new Kroger Shopping Center opened, correct?
Yes, sir.
And the Public Shopping Center across the street opened, correct?
Yes, sir.
These are major commercial retail developments within Dawson County that recently opened, right?
That is correct.
All right, and we also have the Outlet Mall, which opened back some 20, 23 years ago, which is another major retail commercial center within the county, right?
Yes, sir.
All right. And that in part is an explanation for why the increase in the special purpose local option sales tax revenue and the local option sales tax revenue has increased, right?
Yes, sir.
And do you receive any numbers there within your office about what the estimate, or do you have a way to run an estimate of what that indicates of the number of people who are coming to do business here in Dawson County as compared to the residential population?
No, sir, I don't have anything like that. That would probably come from the chamber.
Okay, or an economic development.
Development, something like that.
But you would agree that, based upon your knowledge and experience, that the resident population would not support those commercial retail centers on their own?
Oh, I totally agree with that, yes.
In the course of the entire budget presentation, do you know if there was any part of the budget presentation that included the numbers based upon the amended 2017 budget?
No, sir. It was all on original budget. The comparisons were original, and that's typical.
But within the chairman's presentation, he indicated that there would be no new positions. Is that correct?
I believe at the initial presentation there were no new positions, but there was a position added later on by the time it was finally adopted.
I'll ask you about that. Give me just a second.
Okay.
This is his presentation, part of the chairman's presentation. Proposed budget highlights no new positions, right?
That's correct.
Okay. But if you use only the initial approved 2017 budget, then there would have been two positions added for the planning department pursuant to a budget amendment in April. Is that correct?
That's correct.
So this portion of the budget presentation includes the 2017 budget amendment.
Yes, because when we do the, when we put the budget together, we use position control, and that gives us the number of people and their pay at the, you know, current pay. And so that's how we come up with those numbers for the salary costs.
I understand, but you didn't use the numbers from the budget amendment, only the fact that the positions had been added pursuant to a budget amendment.
And then again, sorry.
You didn't use the numbers for comparison from the 2017 budget amendment, but you used the fact that positions were added pursuant to a budget amendment.
We used the dollar amount of the salary. We used the updated salaries that came about from the salary study. So that's what was put in the budget, was the updated salary.
But if what that number was not included for the purposes of the comparison between 17 and 18.
Right.
All right. That's all I'm asking you.
Yeah, it's in the budget. It just wasn't in the, you know, the 17.
In the comparison.
Yes, in the budget.
But what I'm just trying to make sure I understand that you did include within the chairman's presentation where he says no new positions, that did include an amendment 2017 to add two positions to plan.
Yes.
All right. Now, you were telling me that there were other positions added by the Board of Commissioners when they finally approved the budget on September the 21st.
I believe those positions were added prior to.
I'm sorry, I may have confused you. The planning positions were added pursuant to an April 2017 budget amendment, April the 20th.
Yes.
There were other positions outside of planning department. There were other positions in the fire department that were also approved when the Board of Commissioners approved the budget on September the 21st, correct?
There were nine positions that were funded by the SAFER grant.
And also by drawing funds out of fund balance to fund the county's portion of that, correct?
Yes, sir.
Of approximately $150,000.
I believe that's correct.
So the commissioners exercised their discretion to withdraw from approximately $150,000 from fund balance to fund nine fire department positions.
Yes, sir.
And currently, pending before the Board of Commissioners is a request for funding of the Development Authority of they've asked for $175,000, correct?
That's correct.
And currently pending out of the 18 budget is to withdraw from fund balance to fund it for $135,000, correct?
Yes, sir.
All right. And currently, the county is advertising for an emergency services director position, another position over emergency services, correct?
No, sir. That position is in the budget. It's and there's a person currently in that position. They've just done some restructuring, and that person is stepping back. But this won't be in addition to the budget.
All right, but I'm asking, they're currently advertising for this position, right?
Yes, sir.
And if there's any other funds needed, that would have to come out of fund balance.
Yes, sir, but it's not anticipated that there will be additional funds.
Would you agree with me, Ms. Neikirk, that
the sheriff did not receive an increase in his budget of close to $1 million from 2017 to 2018.
Did you restate the question?
Would you agree with me that the sheriff did not receive an increase of close to $1 million over the 17 budget?
No. Okay. I would not agree. I would say that based on the 2017 budget, the original approved budget, compared to what was approved in 2018, I show that the change was $985,277.
All right. And first, you want to go back to the original approved budget. But that budget was amended, was it not?
Yes, sir.
And then as a result of that amendment in 2017, the sheriff's 2017 budget was increased.
That's correct.
And so what you want to testify to is the original approved budget rather than the amended budget, right? Final budget.
Yes, sir.
And the final budget with those amendments increased the sheriff's 2017 budget by approximately $362,000, didn't it?
Yes, sir.
All right. And so if you back that out of your $985,000 estimate, that would back that up to 600 and some odd thousand, correct?
Okay.
That correct?
I believe so.
All right. And what you're including in his approved budget includes the $260,000 that's in a capital project fund that's restricted, correct?
Yes, sir.
And he has no control over that money.
That's right.
So that should be backed out of that $600,000 that you say has increased his budget.
Well, he's still getting the funds even though he doesn't have, because the comparison from the prior year includes capital. So when you're comparing 1 year to the next, you want to include all the funds that were included in what he was allocated for.
All right. Let me ask you this though. It's restricted. So you amended the budget in 17. And so there's nothing that would prevent the Board of Commissioners from amending the 18 budget and removing that 260 from the budget. Sheriff would have nothing to do about that. There's nothing he could control the way the budget is approved.
I personally can't see the board doing that.
I understand, but they could.
Yes, sir.
All right. And then that $260,000 is so restricted, it's not to be used at all in 2018, is it?
The purpose for that money was for the new CAD system. And the way the board, I guess, structured this is they wanted that money set aside. And then the following year, they would add an additional $260,000, and that would provide the full funding for the new CAD system.
Okay, so that money won't be used at all in 2018, will it?
No, sir.
All right. And as we've gone through with the total budget for the sheriff, it includes SPLOST money of $600,000 that he has no control over.
Well, no, sir. I mean, he orders the cars that he wants, so that's his control over it. I mean, we don't tell him what kind of cars to order or anything. I mean, he orders what he wants. But as far as being able to do something else with it, I don't believe. I mean, like I said, I think that's a legal interpretation. As far as, I know, there's been some question about where it says equipment, so I'm not qualified to answer that question.
All right, but the county's answer says that he has control over $9,100,000 as we've gone through in their answer, correct?
Well, that's the dollar amount that has been approved for his use.
Been approved for his use, but he doesn't have discretion over it, right?
He does over a lot of it. The general fund portion, he has discretion
over. I'm asking you about the SPLOST money. He doesn't have control over that.
No, sir.
Thank you.
redirect?
Just briefly. During the course of 2017, did you come to understand that the sheriff can engage in purchases and contracting, having work done, buying things, changing his payroll decisions around, all without having to follow the Dawson County policies and procedures? Is it your understanding that he can do that?
Yes, sir.
Nonetheless, is it important for your office that those decisions be communicated to you and your staff so that the changes, even if they're not done according to Dawson County policy, that those changes are communicated to your office for purposes of such things as writing checks to vendors, doing payroll checks, whatever it takes in terms of accounting? Is it important that those decisions he makes be effectively communicated to your office?
Yes, sir, very important.
Mr. Homans asked you about the $973,080 budget figure for the sheriff. And he asked that, asked whether or not all of that was subject to the sheriff's discretion, including $600,000 for SPOS. And as I recall, your answer was that it wasn't all subject to his discretion.
That's correct.
If you take that figure, the $9,173,080, and take out the $600,000 SPLOS money from 18, use a calculator if you need to, but taking that 600 out, would that still leave a large amount of money subject to his discretion?
Yes, sir.
Unrestricted money that he can do what he chooses to do.
Yes, sir.
That figure, the $9,173,080, already had removed from it the $260,000 capital, the $112,204, and the $15,000 that he asked you to take out. That's where that $9,173,000 came from, right?
Yes, sir.
So if you take the $600,000 SPOS out from that figure, you end up with $8,573,080. $8,600,000, correct?
Please.
And feel free to calculate it by hand or with a calculator or anything that helps you.
Yes, that would be correct.
So what he's left with is, just for the record, $8,573,080 that are subject to his discretion in terms of the decisions about how to spend it.
Yes, sir.
In making your revenue projections for sales tax purposes, did you consider that the new development in commercial and retail would have some impact on what kind of projections to make?
Yes, we did. In years past, we have never reached the amount that had been projected. And so the chairman asked that we really look hard at the local option sales tax numbers. And so we tried to put in a more realistic number. So, I understand that there's a lot of growth down here at 400. There's a lot of retail. We're very grateful for that because it provides a great revenue source. But what people have to keep in mind, that it takes $10 million in new sales to get $100,000 in sales tax. So that's a lot of extra sales, you know, to, you know, $100,000 is a lot of money, but when you're looking at a $30 million government, it doesn't go very far.
In making those projections back in the middle up through September 21st, 2017, did you take into account the best numbers that you had available for where sales tax collections were trending?
Yes, we did.
And again, it's all estimates other than looking back at the historical collections.
Right.
Anything you put in a budget for next year or for now this year is a projection.
That's correct.
It's an estimate. Is that correct?
That is correct.
I think that's all I have for this witness.
Recross?
No, thank you.
You can come down. You got one more witness, is that correct?
Yes, sir.
Okay. I think we'll take 10 minutes at this point, and then we'll recommence with your witness. We'll take 10 minutes.
Thank you. Mm-hmm.